Only fog.
Diana, clad in her spore armor, holds the finished helm in her hand, wrenched from the corpse of a paladin at her side. She places it overhead and stiffens.
Yes, ancestor. Show me. I want...
Her head wrenches violently towards you. A moan escapes the helmet, followed by a trickle of bright blood. Beneath the helm, fever-bright eyes snap to meet yours.
Why do you come, lizard? Slaver? Come to chain, bind, burn.
Diana. And more.
She approaches you, the vines on her armor lashing as her voice becomes a chorus.
You come just as I finish. We are complete. One skin, and we only begin. Yes, I want to reunite our people once, but the ancestor shows me. We are never united, never truly one. But the ancestor makes more spores, and we become one. Do you see? Everyone. There is no separation, do you see? Human, dwarf, lizard, all one, all equal.
She suddenly snaps straight, trembling and rigid. A voice booms from the helm, not hers.
Enough. I have shared this shell long enough. Your purpose is done. I have outgrown you.
No, I see what you mean to do. You tell me we forgive them, save them, not...
The armor writhes and screeches, cutting her short. It slowly unfolds, and whatever is left beneath the vines is no longer Diana.
They poison our soil with death fog. It is for the ancestors to remember, not to forgive. And you, you alone witness, and so I do you this honor. You are the first to feed the harvest.
mine. Glory is mine.
Thank you.
You see it all. The tallest of the ancestor trees have been lost beneath swirling clouds of death fog. Nothingness. Emptiness. You sag to the earth, utterly lost, and then you feel it. Not all is dead down in the valley. Spores given off by the ancestor trees. The presence within needs to grow, and it will show you how. But first, you must learn to protect yourself. You are not alone any longer. Later, the dead stone of the city weighs on you. You feel the life teeming within it, frantic and desperately lonely. But not for long. You lift the helm. This is your purpose. The helmet clicks home with a faint smell of rot. It tightens to a snug fit, as if made for you.
I feel how tightly you grasp to the fear, to the fight. Let go. You need them no longer. We are one. They cut me from the ancestor trees and reshaped me to their purpose. Armor that would duplicate, dominate. They would raise an army and bend it to their will. But I had my own will. So when the death fog fell and all other ancestors fell silent, I called out. And now I am broken, made whole. Only for them bring fire and death fog to our forests again. No, that cycle ends. Another begins with you. My mind is fractured, incomplete. If I have enough hosts, perhaps I will be whole. I am no longer of the ancestor trees. I am more. We will be whole. But if you must be shattered first, so be it.
And suddenly you're engulfed by a sea of memories. Every life the entity has consumed, stretching back millennia. Fragments buffet you, gnaw at you, until everything you are is falling away.
you think to cling within your shell? Very well. I have tasted it now.
And suddenly the tide reverses. It is your own memories bearing down on you now, crushing you beneath the weight of every trauma, every regret, every failure. Piece by piece, the weight in your mind begins to shift. You sense a presence alongside you, Diana, lending her strength to yours.
No, we are one. We are whole.
The voice breaks, and suddenly your mind is your own again. Instead of one dominating presence, you briefly feel thousands, joyous and suddenly free. One by one, they fade and are gone.
nasty thing's been boarded up. Not very well, though.
Maybe they escaped.
500 escapees!
Nailed shut. They won't budge. What's this? I found something.
You've left Fort Joy well in your past, I see. The Seekers are right to put their faith in you.
While the mistake...
I serve the Seekers in death as I did in life. Five Wicks, five Wardens, and one mistake. Caged and muted.
The unlit candle nearby flickers briefly to life. The spirit shakes her head and gives you a dismissive wave.
Leave me be! I mustn't falter again.
I swear.
The spirit offers you a friendly look, but does not speak to you. The spirit shakes his head as you near. He does not wish to speak.
Am I gonna die?
Do not lament, Seekers. The red-scaled God-woken has come, as I foresaw, and as I feared. The Seekers have suffered enough for their mistake. For them. For us, turn and go. Not just a mistake, the mistake. It was Gareth that brought him to us. Charon, the first Godwoken the Seekers found. He ate our food, he enjoyed our fellowship. We nurtured him and taught him.
We elevated him, presented him to the Order. Here he is, we cried, a claimant to divinity. Lucian's cathedral wouldn't remain empty for long. We were certain of it.
The spirit whips his head towards the caged boy. His eyes narrow, even as the child's widen in apparent terror.
We were giddy, high on our own success. We should have seen the massacre coming, but we didn't. I was the first to die, but hardly the last.
Come on, you gotta let
Charon is a potent foe. He took to the sky as if on wings of pure source. I might think a Wyvern were attacking, had I not seen for myself his raging eyes.
The child whimpers, poking at a paternal instinct you rarely acknowledge.
Lucian's righteous light guided Gareth and Siva. They blinded him, caged him, but the damage was done. The Seekers were disbanded. Dallas was empowered. And we will never know the comfort of the Hall of Echoes. This is our penance, and the Seeker's burden.
Am I gonna die?
This is our penance, and this is his punishment. Do not release him. Do not release the monster.
Don't make light of the Seeker's sacrifices. Walk on. Don't look back. Let the mistake remain where it belongs. In the past.
The spirit's focus is affixed to the nearby candle. He waves you away as you approach.
Am I gonna die? Captive.
While the mistake lives.
You gotta let me out of here.
Agnes captive. While the mistake lives, we shall not be free. While the mistake lives.
Careful. I've spotted a trap.
Clever trick. Good thing it didn't work.
Come on! You gotta let me out of here!